The Pap Attack.
I'm pulling for Rush Limbaugh. You know, when I saw Rush speak at CPAC a couple of weeks ago, the whole scene there triggered what I can only describe as a political epiphany for me. I mean, think about it. There was Rush looking like Tony Soprano, black silk shirt opened at the chest, black silk sport coat, gold chains and all. And as I watch Rush demagogue his way through an angry political manifesto tailored for that easily excitable crowd, I saw the possibility of a new political party emerging in America. More importantly, I saw a way for the GOP to save itself from that Rush image that's like a ball and chain around their neck. You see, I believe RNC Chairman Michael Steele saw the same thing that I saw before he began growing feathers around his legs and apologized. Steele saw the potential for a clean break from the fringe moonbat crowd that's driving the GOP to a place of political and social irrelevance. Steele should urge Rush to launch a breakaway party. The analysis on Rush is easy. Historically, he's had zero impact on the outcome of elections. Every day during the 2008 presidential primaries, he attacked John McCain and predicted McCain would never win the primaries. All the anti-McCain hate talk Rush could dish out had no effect on the outcome at all. Next, Rush tried to show that he had political muscle by calling Barack Obama communist and a Kenyan illegal immigrant. Rush was certain that his vast political influence would end Obama's presidential hopes. But the truth is, Limbaugh's political influence is not vast at all, and that's what most people misunderstand. Obama won by a landslide and made the GOP look like a flailing southern regional political party. Let's buy the Limbaugh BS spin, though. Let's assume that 13 million people at some time during a week listen to Rush's rants. If every one of those listeners does exactly what Rush begs them to do as they march off the cliff, they're going to have zero impact on U.S. elections. In the last presidential election, 125 million people voted, and the Democrats, whom Rush vilifies daily, pulled off sweeping victories all over America anyway. Rush has an approval rating with the general public that's even more dismal than the one that W. left behind when he left office. Gallup puts raging Rush's favorables around 28%. An entire generation of young voters tuned Rush out years ago. Instead, they tune into places like Jon Stewart's Daily Show or the Colbert Report to follow their politics. Those are places where viewers aren't laughing with Rush, they're laughing at Rush. Timing is everything, and now is the time for Steele to urge Rush to launch his own political party. The GOP deserves better than Limbaugh. There should never be a day when the name Limbaugh is going to be spoken in the same breath as Lincoln. History has shown us that the fringe of both major political parties have predictably emerged as new American political organizations. Unhappy extremists who were out of touch with the mainstream, well, they gave birth to the Constitution Party, the American Fascist Party, and the Freedom Party. Mr. Limbaugh, I hear opportunity knocking, and the GOP desperately needs you to open that door.
The Pap Attack on Air America Radio Network.